The OnePlus 3 packs some serious specs considering its £309 asking price, one of which is the 16 megapixel camera jutting out from the back side. But is it a case of snap happy or snap crappy? Here's our OnePlus 3 camera review. Give the phone's power button a quick double tap and you're thrust into the camera app, which is reasonably streamlined but not quite as user friendly as the likes of the Moto G4's app. There are two different settings buttons, one used to toggle the timer mode, aspect ratio and on-screen grid, while the other switches between the different camera modes, including the video mode. Thankfully, you can also swap to video by flicking your finger up the screen, which is something of a relief. The OnePlus 3's camera shutter is super fast once you get snapping, with a nippy autofocus that can be overridden with a tap of the screen. Hit the shutter button and your photo takes pretty much instantaneously, and on full auto mode, you get good looking pics pretty much every time. Every snap is rammed with tiny details, as you'd expect from a flagship phone. Colours stand out nicely, but hues are also realistically reproduced, rather than boosted artificially. Tricky contrast is also well handled by the HDR feature. Shoot against the bright sky, for instance, and you'll still get a crisp, clear shot with very little oversaturation. Macro snaps are particularly impressive, with sharp results from a very short distance. When the lighting conditions drop, the OnePlus 3's f2.0 sensor still holds up quite well. Images are dark, but not too grainy, with some impressive detail captured in evening shots, while the LED flash does a fantastic job of lighting up a scene. The OnePlus 3's camera can't quite match the likes of the Samsung Galaxy S7 in low light performance, but it's not far off. Of course, moving subjects in dimly lit rooms will usually be a blur, especially slightly hyper kitties. You can also dive into manual mode if you want a little more control, although you do at least get a brightness slider in the auto mode when manually focusing, like on the Moto G4. The OnePlus 3's manual mode lets you mess around with the ISO levels and so on if you need to capture a very specific shot. And if you're keen to get the best possible results, the OnePlus 3 also offers raw image shooting, something found on a few full price mobiles. The OnePlus 3 can shoot full HD and 4K video footage, although 4K recording is understandably restricted to 10 minutes, and results are once again okay. Focus stays sharp when you're flicking between near and distant points, and harsh light is handled well too. Sadly, the image stabilization isn't as strong as many rivals, including the cheaper Moto G4, with some significant shake as you take each step. Audio quality is also rather iffy. Outside, there's clear distortion, possibly a case of wind infecting the mic, and even inside it can be quite tinny at times. The OnePlus 3's 8-megapixel selfie camera is a respectable little snapper, with a wide-angle lens so you can cram in lots of heads. As you'd expect, the lens picks up plenty of detail, which isn't great news if you look as tired as Chris does in these test shots. Sadly, in low light, there's quite a lot of grain. Rival phones like the Xperia X, Galaxy S7, and Moto G4 again perform more strongly, capturing cleaner, more attractive shots. Hopefully you enjoyed this camera review of the OnePlus 3, and if you have any questions about the phone, you can drop us a line down below in the comments, and you can read the full review and camera review on recombi.com/mobile. Thanks for watching.